C# includes a set of preprocessor directives that are mainly used for conditional compilation. Although the C# compiler does not have a separate preprocessor like C or C++ compilers, the directives shown here are processed as if there was one. That is, they appear to be processed before the actual compilation takes place. The preprocessor directives are easily distinguished from normal programming code in that they start with a hash sign. They must always occupy a line that is separate from anything else except for single-line comments. Whitespace may optionally be included before and after the hash mark. The first directives we'll look at are the if and endif directives, which specifies a section of code that will be included or excluded based on a given condition. Most often, this condition will be a conditional compilation symbol. These symbols are created using the define directive followed by the symbol's name, which will then cause a conditional expression using that condition to be evaluated as true. The symbol will remain defined only within the current source file, starting from the line where the symbol is defined. It's also possible to use the undef or undefined directive to disable a previously defined symbol. Just as the C# if statement, we can optionally include any number of else if or elif directives and one final else directive. Conditional directives may also be nested within another conditional section. In longer conditionals, it's a good practice to add comments to the endif directive to help keep track of which if directive it corresponds to. Next, we have two diagnostic directives, error and warning. Error is used to abort a compilation by generating a compilation error. The directive can optionally take a parameter that specifies the error's description. Similar to error, the warning directive generates a compilation warning message. Another directive that affects the compiler's output is line. This directive is used to change the line number and optionally the source file name that is displayed when an error or warning occurs during compilation. This is mainly useful if we're using a program that combines the source files into an intermediate file which is then compiled. The last directives are region and end region. These two delimit a section of code that can be expanded or collapsed using the outlining feature of Visual Studio. Just like the conditional directives, regions can be nested any number of levels deep.